In this video, we'll see about the test run. Whenever I execute a particular single test case, that will create a separate test run record. Those records will be stored under the test run tab itself. The number of times I execute a single test case, that many number of times I'll create separate test run records. So let us see practically how do we work on this test runs part.
Now, once you execute a one single test instance, the details about that executed test case or executed instance will be stored under this test runs. Suppose if you execute this login test case 20 times, all 20 times each record will be stored under this test run. So if I go to this test run, and if you observe here, there's number given as 23, that's a run ID. If you're doing it for the first time, it will show as number 1. If you keep on doing it, the ID will keep on changing. It is a unique ID number. This is the run name. When I started the execution, I had a run name and this was the run name, which says as date and time, both are given here. That's only a date which is given. The name of the test case is given, the name of the configuration, status, and so on. So all the details about that particular run have been stored in the test runs. Here in the bottom, if you see, that's comments. If you want, you can add some comments here. Reports, you can see each step, whatever status have been done, what they have entered in the username or what they have entered in the password, and what are the actual results will be given here. If you go to attachments, you can attach something, history part, and also for the test description, you can add here. Now, if I want to understand more details about this particular test run, I have to click on this ID number, that is run ID. If I click on this run ID, I'll be getting a dialog box and details about this particular run ID. Now, if you want to change this thing, you can just rename this run. So I'll say as login attempt 1, something like that. And if you see, there's a status, test set name, and there's a tester name. Few options you can modify, like status and the tester name. Whereas this is the job of the admin person. He will be making some modification at the backend, which will increase or decrease the number of fields, which will make mandatory or you can say as optional fields which are present here. So it is completely depending upon your site admin who is doing the modification, which company is allowing which fields and so on. And if you observe the next tab that's given as test description, this has already been written here when we were creating a test case. And if you see the left one, that says as report. Every step, the report has been given with the actual steps expected and the description. And if you want to see the steps, you can just click on this place in the steps. And again, the description expected will be given. Attachments, you can attach. It will say what parameters have been used in this particular test run. So these are the parameters. If you want to link a defect, suppose your test case fails. And if you want to link a defect, you can just simply select this link defects. You can either link an existing defect, or you can create a new defect and link it. And the last one, we have some history. Whatever changes you have made to particular test run, you can find out here itself. That is nothing but the history part. So I'll just simply click on this close button and I'll say yes, I don't want to save this. No changes have to be saved here. Right. So I hope you have understood what happens when we execute one test case and how it is saved into the test runs part. So you see that that's a test run what we have executed. Now remember, with every execution, if I execute one test instance or one test case 20 times, I'll be getting the run ID 20 times. I'll be getting separate IDs. So it is easy for me to identify what happened in which test run. So I hope you have understood, and that's all for this video.